So you know what's on the agenda today? It's a question. I've had a couple students reach out to me and say, "Hey, I need help with something." It's like, "All right, what do you need help with?" "Well, I'm having trouble with this one exercise." I'm like, "All right. Well, what's your question?" I just need help with it." And that's difficult without distance learning, right? That situation is challenging during the run of a normal class. What's your question? "I just need help." Well, that's not a question, right? So one of the things that's incredibly important when it comes to learning is the ability to ask a question. Now, believe it or not, one of the most important questions that someone can ask is, "Wait, what?" Which is a great question, because that question means that you're either paying attention, which is the first part of learning, or you're attempting to pay attention and you just kind of spaced out for a minute, which is understandable. And so when you space out, you ask, "Wait, what?" And that is a question that's useful, again, during a normal class. Now, in distance learning, that question can't be asked to a professor or to a teacher. It can totally be asked to yourself. Now, when I'm reading something, I ask myself, "Wait, what?" all the time, right? And it's usually something to do with like a direction I just read, or a word that I just read and I didn't understand, or something that just didn't make sense to me at the moment. Like, how is that particular thing possible? So for distance learning, I wish the students would be able to ask themselves, "Wait, what?" for maybe a piece of direction that I had written or something that I said in a video, and then that is a point that they can reach out to me and then say, "Hey, Mr. Katz, I came across this thing and I didn't understand what you meant when you said blank. Well, how do I find the height of something if it's not straight?" Well, I don't know, but if I ask, "What's your question?" they can respond with an actual question. "I didn't understand this word," or "I didn't understand where that number came from," or "I didn't understand how to read this particular symbol." Those are questions that I could totally work with. All things learning, all knowledge, right? All discovery, all sorts of new pieces of understanding for humanity begin with a question. So it's super important. I get where a student feels completely overwhelmed by something that's so completely foreign. Maybe I'm presenting a concept and it's just like, it's so bizarre that you can't even wrap your head around it. Everything begins with one tiny question. And the question could be as simple as, "Wait, what?" Those are the questions that we can deal with. Those are the questions that can push us forward and get us into actual knowledge and understanding. So for whatever it is that you're learning, if you're out there, whatever it is that you're learning, whatever it is that you're dealing with, it's something that's so ominous, so completely ununderstandable, then start with one tiny question. What does that word mean? Or where did that number come from? Or even just as simple as, "Wait, what?" I'm gonna leave with a quote from one of my favorite bands, Rage Against the Machine, in the song Fistful of Steel. "I won't stop because I know the power of a question."